Hi, greetings, Remy here, and welcome to my channel. Today, we are diving into one of the most crucial aspects of 3D printing that often gets overlooked, the first layer. Whether you are a beginner or an experienced maker, you have probably encountered prints that warp, shift, or fail entirely. More often than not, these issues stem from improper first layer setting. The first layer is essentially the foundation of your print. If it's not laid down perfectly, the rest of your print is at risk. From bed leveling and Z-axis offset to adhesion and surface finish, the success of your entire print hinges on getting the first layer just right. Key points to note for the first layer: bed leveling, bed adhesion, correct Z offset, filament temperature, impact on surface finish, and the first layer speed. Conducting a first layer test before printing the full model can save time and material, allowing you to adjust for optimal adhesion and leveling. In this video, I'll be focusing on one specific aspect, first layer speed. We'll talk about why slowing down your first layer is crucial and how it affects adhesion, precision, and overall print quality. By the end, you'll have a better understanding of why paying attention to your first layer speed can make all the difference in your prints. The first layer speed is typically set slower than the rest of the print to allow the filament to be laid down more precisely. Lower speed improves adhesion, giving the print time to bond effectively with the print bed surface. Slow speeds help the hot filament stay in contact with the print bed long enough to bond properly, reducing the risk of warping, especially for larger prints. For materials like ABS or PETG, which are prone to warping, this slow approach is even more crucial. Performing a first layer test can help you fine-tune the right speed for your specific material and bed setup. Start slow, around 20 to 30 millimeters per second, and gradually increase the speed in small increments. This allows you to identify the optimal speed for adhesion without sacrificing print quality. Now, let's see few of the test print. As of recording this video, I'm using OrcaSlicer 2.1.1. For this test print, I have used Ender 3 with 0.4 mm nozzle and PLA filament. Now let's see some of the settings that I'll be focusing on in this test print. Once you open OrcaSlicer, under Prepare, then Print Profile, and then Strength, under Walls, Wall Loops, Top Bottom Shells, look for Bottom Surface Pattern, Top Bottom Solid Infill Wall Overlap, then Speed, under Speed, First Layer Speed, First Layer, First Layer Infill. Throughout my test print, I'll be using this model, which is X96, Y61, Z.28. 0.28 is also my first layer height. Why this dimension? Please don't ask me, I just took some random numbers. Now let's see our first test print. In this, first layer speed 100, first layer infill speed 100, surface pattern monotonic, and overlap is 25%. The first layer speed 100 applies to the walls, these two walls. Infill speed 100 applies to this monotonic pattern, which goes diagonal. And the overlap percentage 25 is the overlap of this infill pattern, which overlaps on the outer walls. By looking at this test print, it is very clear that printing at 100, the filament does not stick well to the bed. Even the outer walls are not straight over here, and in infill pattern does not stick well. Due to this, the overlapping also does not form correctly. Let's zoom in over here and see. Now if you look here, this does go up until the wall, since it has very less time to stick to the bed. It does not stick over here, neither it sticks to the wall over here. and that is why it immediately curls back. So if you see, this is like a blob over here, that is due to the nozzle going very fast and returning back, and it doesn't have enough time to stick to the bed, and so it doesn't even overlap onto the wall. Now let's look at the second test print. Here the speed settings remain the same as the first test print, also the overlap, but only the pattern changes from monotonic to concentric. So this also does not work by changing the pattern. If you look closely over here, it moves fast and doesn't have enough time to stick to the bed. Let's look at the third test print. Over here, the speed settings remains the same, but overlap is set to 100%. So from default 25%, now the overlap, infill wall overlap is 100%. If you see, it's much better than before, but over here still, it does not stick well to this area over here. But if you look at the overlap, it's done a good job. So the overlap has actually improved. Now let's look at the next test print. Here, overlap percent remains the same as the previous test print, which is 100% overlap. But first layer speed is reduced from 100 to 80 mm per second. So the wall and the infill wall and the infill speed is set to 80 mm. This is much better, but overlap is at 100%. So let's see at the overlap as well. So now if you see, it's 100% overlap and nearly touching to the outer wall. It's overlapping the inner wall and also touching to the outer wall. Here is the next test print. Here the speed is same as the previous test print, 80 mm per second for the first layer and first layer infill, but the overlap is reduced to 25%, which is the default overlap percentage. If you see over here, it is better, the infill laying, also the outer wall seems to be a little better, but the overlapping is not good at all. So we'll zoom in and see over here. It doesn't have enough time, or because of high speed, it doesn't have enough time to stick to the outer wall. Here is the next test print. Speed is set to 80 mm for the outer and infill, and overlap percent is increased to 50%. So this print looks much better, but if you look over here at the overlap, this isn't that good. There are gaps which is not good. So this gap should not be there. So we'll try to see by increasing the overlap if we can improve these gaps, or we'll try to reduce the speed. So we'll see in the next test print. Here is the next test print. The speed remains the same, 80 mm, and overlap percentage is increased to 75, from 50 to 75%. Still we don't see much improvement. Let's see by increasing the overlap further and see if we can achieve better result. Here is the next test print, where speed is set to 80 and overlap is set to 90%. This gives a very good result. The overlap is also good, and the adhesion is also good. So this seems to be a good result over here. So until now we have seen that higher the speed, higher the overlap percentage must be. So too much of overlap is also not good. So we need to find an optimal speed and the overlap percentage. So let's try to see by less speed and less overlap if we can achieve a better result. So this test print, what we see here, where speed is set to 50 mm for the first layer and the infill, that is for the outer wall and the infill pattern, and the overlap percentage is set to 25. So over here 25% seem does not work at all for anything. So we'll look at the next test print by lowering the speed. Now let's see this test print. Over here the infill percentage The overlap in fill percentage is same as the previous print, which is 25%, but the speed is reduced to 30 mm per second for both the outer and the infill. This does not show any improvement, so we'll see by next print, we'll see by increasing if we achieve better result, increasing the overlap percentage. Here is the next test print. The speed is 30 mm for the outer and the infill, and overlap percentage, the infill overlap percentage is set to 50%. If we zoom in and see, we see better result over here. So, but still it's not, the gap is still there. We need to try and see if we can fill up this gap. This next test print, the speed is 30 mm and the infill percentage is increased to 60%. We see a better result than the previous test print, but let's zoom in and see if there are any gaps. So we'll focus on this area. We can see that there are gaps over here. So we need to increase a bit further and see if we can achieve better result. Let's analyze this test print where the speed remains the same, 30 mm for the outer wall and for the infill pattern. And the infill wall overlap is set to 70%. We see good result over here, but let's zoom in and see if there are any gaps. So with this 70% overlap, I don't see any gaps. Now that I have found a sweet spot for overlap, which is 70%, next, I will increase the speed and see if I can go a little higher. Now let's analyze our next test print. The infill wall overlap remains the same as the previous test print, which is 70%, but the speed is increased from 30 to 50 for both outer and the infill. This seems to be a good result with 50 as well, and I don't see any gaps. Now let's see our next test print. Here the infill wall overlap percentage remains the same as the previous, which is 70%, but the speed is increased from 50 to 60 for both walls and the infill. Let's analyze and see. I don't see a good result over here. If you see, there are gaps over here. Now keeping the same speed, which is 60, we'll try and increase the overlap percentage and see if we can achieve a better result. Now let's see this next test print. Here the infill wall overlap percentage is increased to 80%. So previously it was 70%, now it is set to 80%, and speed remains the same, which is 60 mm for the outer, for the walls and the infill pattern. So result seems to be improved over here by increasing the infill wall overlap percentage. So we don't see any gaps. Here is the next test print. Now the previous test print gave me good result with speed set to 60 and infill wall overlap set to 80%. For this test print, the infill wall overlap remains the same, which is 80%, but speed I have increased further to 80, from 60 to 80. I can see some artifacts over here. If you can see, there are gaps, and over here as well, here and here. So speed of 80 does not work good on this bed surface for me. So I will stick to 60, which gives me the optimal result with 80% overlap. Now let's see the comparison of the test prints, which have shown a good result. We have four test prints over here. The one over here, which is 80, speed is set to 80 mm and overlap is 90. The next one over here is 30 and overlap is 70. The third one over here is 50 and overlap is 70. And the last one over here, speed is 60 and overlap is 80. To select which one is good is up to you guys. You all need to decide by doing the test print. Do not take the exact result or exact settings what I have. Do test it yourself and derive the values based on your test print. Settings differ for each printer, depends on the type of filament, the bed, the adhesion that you all are using, the speed. So select the configuration that you all are using as an optimal value. Take this as a reference to do the test. For me, I would go with this setting. Why not this, which has a higher speed, which is 80 compared to over here. And if you see, the time difference is like 1 minute faster, not that big difference. Over here, the overlap is 90%. I would rather prefer to stay below as less as possible on the overlap, provided it doesn't show any gaps. Best would be to go with this settings, but here the speed is too less, 30 and 50. So for me, I would select this settings as my print speed for the first layer and the overlap percentage as 80. Now in all of my test print, you all must have observed this dark line over here, then over here, and here. Just ignore this line. This is because of the bed. My nozzle has scratched the bed. You can see over here, this is the line which indicates that mark. Please note, no matter what speed you set, the actual speed will be derived by the slicer considering different factors. To know the actual speed, just click on this color scheme over here. If it's hidden like this, just expand drop down, click on this and it will drop down or expand, and then click on this line type and select speed. This will tell you the speed what it is printing at. Now if you see here, these are the walls, the outer walls. It is printing at 100 mm, and the infill, solid infill, it is printing at 60 mm. We have set this 160, so it is taking 160. So if you go above, if you see here, I set to 200, but it didn't go at 200, it maxed out to 147. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please hit the like and share button, and also let me know in the comments on your views. Thank you. God bless.